Que cargo, amiga.
Can you believe it? I was singing in the studio with my Jack Fashion.
Can you believe it? It's okay. My career is done. If I do nothing else, I'm all right. How you doing, bro?
Oh, I'm fine, darling. So good. It's going down.
That's such a beautiful song. What inspired you to write that song?
Holy Spirit is it's God. Mm. God inspired me.
Right.
Yeah. Right. See, when you're humble and to God, and you are faithful to God, it will give you inspiration.
Right.
And inspiration is part of the life of every human.
Right.
Inspiration in every kind of field of realization of all any field of specialization.
Right.
So inspiration keeps you young. Mm-hmm. Inspiration keeps you alive. But money cannot keep you young and alive. Money can only answer your needs.
Right.
So in my life, I learned not to follow the power of money, but the power of the Most High. Because the Most High keeps you young.
Okay.
Which is called Holy Spirit.
Holy Spirit. And talking about Holy Spirit, my
Holy Spirit, yeah.
I have some people asking you some questions here. So let's see. You know, my listeners, they're very stubborn like me, because I'm very stubborn.
Yeah.
My listeners are very stubborn. Mm-hmm. So let me see. I've got a few questions for you, but a lot of them are diverted towards spirituality. So let me see. I saw a couple here. Where is it? Oh, come on, Elvina. Look for these things. Look for it. But anyway, you know, we're talking about how there was a spiritual problem. It wasn't narcotics. It wasn't connected to drugs and all that. People are curious. You know, I'm looking for the tweets. But a couple of listeners have said, what does Majek mean by spiritual? Please explain further. You know, they want to know what happened. And if it was a spiritual problem, how are you coming out of it now? I know it's through the Holy Ghost and you're a masterman. You say you're also a Ladura.
Yeah.
So how have you conquered this negative spirit that has been haunting you, so to speak? They want to know.
Yeah, the power of God, the power of Holy Ghost, you know, the power of God. You know, as long as you believe in God, you see, it's in the Bible, it said, they that trust in the Lord shall be like Mount Zion, that can never be moved, but abide forever. Mm. And in the same Bible, it's written, it said, where I and I is not fighting against flesh and blood, but spiritual wickedness in high and low places. So if I put my spirit, my problem on drug, I'll be deceiving my share. Mm. It's a spiritual problem.
Okay, so spiritual from where? From home? From people who want to bring you down? From the higher realm? From which, you know, why? Why would...
No,
is it from other humans?
No, it's not from home. It's not from any human. It's... You know, it said... Be careful. In the Bible, same Bible says, be careful of what you ask from God. You might just get it. Mm. So, I would say my problem is, it's not a home problem.
Okay.
It's not hatred or jealousy from human beings. Mm. It's that certain vows, you know, to be in the Lord, you got to make some vows. And when you make vows, you have to keep the vow. Mm-hmm. And if you can't keep the vow, there's repercussions, there's backfires.
So you didn't keep your vows?
I didn't keep some certain vows. I suffer for the vows I didn't keep. So, you know, I don't believe in any human being.
Right.
So, you know, although I use drugs, but, you know, drugs was not the main issue of my problem.
Right.
But weed just rattled my vibration.
So you didn't use anything other than weed? You didn't use cocaine or crack?
No. Only weed I use.
Heroin, just weed?
Ganja, yeah, I use ganja.
Right. Okay, let's move on. I have some people yapping you here on my check. I'm going to tell you. He said, someone said, Julius Ebadaji, I hope I pronounced your name right, darling. You say, how can my check say that the Nigerian police are not brutal? Hey! Majek, they're challenging you. So how can you say Nigerian police are not brutal? Because they've not been brutal to you, perhaps. So, like I said, that was the first time I heard, you know, that, you know, Nigerian police are cool. You know what I'm saying?
No, Nigerian police, like in America or Europe or Asia. Mm-hmm. When the police stop you, you gotta respect the law, man. You gotta say they are brutal. If you don't respect them because they say they're taking bribe. I don't support it. You don't need to take bribe, you know? If the government is taking care of them. Mm-hmm. Yeah. European police don't take bribe.
So do you think that if the government was taking care of the police, they wouldn't take bribe?
No. They're doing their job. Yeah, they won't take bribe. Mm-hmm. They're not being taken. See, I investigated. Many people don't understand, you know, because I've been to Ikeja, Lagos police station. I went to that area. If you see their house, sometimes they get light. Mm. They use they don't get generator.
But because they're not keeping pay, is that an excuse to take bribe? Because I mean, a lot of people are not getting.
No, paid. Excuse me. They don't have to get paid. As a government official, like the police people, mm-hmm. they need governmental amenities, mm. housing, feeding, and free education for their children.
Right.
That's what happened abroad.
Right.
But they don't have that.
Right.
So they must take bribe.
Hmm. Well, my Jack bro, you know, as much as I respect you,
yeah.
me not think I agree with that. Me think Nigerian police are full of but I'm not gonna I'm very controversial. So yeah, I'm not gonna even, because there was even one that insulted me yesterday, you know, on the street when I asked him why he wasn't doing a certain thing that was his job, and he insulted me and I finished him. I'm not gonna say what I told him because I can't say it on air, but I finished the guy. The guy was dumbstruck. Police, whether you are being supported by Nigerian government or not, you've taken your job, so do your job. Do it and do it well and stop taking bribe and being a nuisance. I'd rather taser a policeman than an armed robber, man.
No, not just the police. Police are the people that take care of the street.
Mm, they should continue.
Yeah, you have to respect them. You know?
All right.
You have to respect the
police. They have to respect me too. Before I respect you.
Yeah, why not?
But anyway, on to lighter things. Yeah, I know you've worked with Tracy Chapman.
Yeah.
Jimmy Cliff.
Yes.
Uncle Jimmy Cliff, actually.
Yeah.
The late great Michael Jackson.
Yeah.
Snoop Dogg.
Oh, yeah.
And Beyonce.
Beyonce.
You've also worked with Alpha Blondy.
Yeah.
You've also worked with Lucky Dube.
Yeah.
Is there someone that you haven't worked with that you would like to work with? Someone that's still very, 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 alive, very in the working atmosphere. Is there someone you'd really like to work with, apart from me, that you haven't worked with?
Yeah, spiritually, I cannot really figure it out right now because I just started my own label. It's called Underground System Records.
Right.
So, after my sojourn in the music business, that's why I have my management, Tito and JG.
Yeah.
They are here with me in the studio.
Yeah.
We're trying to create the Underground System Records.
Yeah.
To help younger artists.
Right.
Upcoming artist.
Right.
People I really want to work with, because of the legacy that the Fellani Kulakbo left behind.
Yes.
The person I really want to work with, apart from the American musicians. The American musicians is not a big deal to me right now.
Mm.
The person I really want to work with in my heart is Femi Anikulakbo.
Ah.
My son. Yeah. So, I think. And you too, I want to work with Avina. So Femi Anikulakbo is one of my first choice. Apart from Two-Face.
Ah, Two-Baba.
Two-Face, yeah. So I like Two-Face because he respects me and knows my value, and I have my mind. So I working with other artists is not my prerogative right now.
Right.
But we're trying to create our own recording company called Underground System Records.
Right. Mm. Right.
So Underground System Records is gonna be a recording company that you're gonna be working with. Younger artists,
right.
And so I can promote them. What I'm saying? Yeah. It's not only me.
Mm.
And, but people I really want to work with right now, that I'm really, really interested to work with Femi Kuti and Two-Face. Yeah.
Well, that's a beautiful thing.
And Elvina. One love. Yeah.
So that's a beautiful thing, wanting to bring up young artists
Yeah,
and
younger
helping them,
yeah,
helping
not
them
just me,
break out into music. Yeah.
Exactly.
That's a beautiful thing, Ajay.
Exactly.
So tell me, what's your favorite food?
My favorite food? I like a starch and banga soup.
Correct.
Area.
Your favorite color?
Color? I like the purple color.
Purple, like my son.
And orange.
My son loves purple.
Yeah.
Let me see. Favorite, I can't ask you this one, it's too difficult. I was going to say favorite musician, but I know you have a lot, so I won't ask you that one. Let me see what else. Favorite animal?
I'm a tiger. I'm from the cat family.
Oh.
I like the cat.
You like the cat?
Yeah, and the dogs.
Alright, okay.
Yeah, I like the cat.
Okay, well, I've had so much fun with you.
Thank you.
And so privileged that you came into my show.
Thank you.
Really look forward to hearing your new album and playing it.
Yeah.
Really look forward to working with you. I'm going to come and disturb you and work with you in the studio. Who knows?
We're going to do it,
who
baby.
Knows what's
you
happen.
Can sing. I love it. This is not partiality. You can do it, baby. Shine, you know, yeah, it's going down.
And, so glad you took your time out. You've been with me for over an hour, and I am so, so grateful for having you here. And I hope you come back to Classic FM very, very soon.
Thank you, darling.
Thank you.
One love.
On that note, do you have anything to say to, like, you know, young artists that are coming up that are struggling, that think things cannot happen, or people that are struggling with spirituality or drugs and they think there's no hope? Please say something to them. Say something to give them hope.
Yeah, what I would say to every human and every artist that's trying to survive in the music industry is that the first thing is that they must be close to God. You know, prayer works, you know, they must be prayerful. If you can fast, they fast. If you can't fast, but you're prayerful. Your prayer answered all things. Prayer of faith. If they are Muslims, they go to mosque. If they are Christians, they go to church.
Mm.
You know?
Yeah.
And serve God with all their heart and their mind.
Yeah.
With God, everything is possible. That's what I would say.
Right.
Believe in God. That's all.
That's
all
right.
Is well.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah.
Yomi King Ibrahim says, Majek Fashek is a legend. We're proud of him, despite all his challenges. Reign again for United Nigerians, Abujans.
Nice.
Dominic Akman says, lovely, revealing, and very personal. His person, music, and Niger, beware, be aware. Majek, please. Yeah.
Amen.
Beautiful comment.
Thank
you know,
you
have so many fans.
Oh,
so glad, Dakwa Salami says, so glad to hear from Majek Fashek tonight. I'm happy for you, brother man. Live on. Then Elvis Okere says, Femi Kuti and Tubaba, that's a great choice. Tubaba is humble and gets reggae vibes in another system.
Yeah.
Ah, Yomi King Ibrahim says, baby, ask him to sing, please.
Yeah.
So before you go, maybe you can give us a line. What am I going to play next? So long, too long.
Yeah.
So can you give us a couple of lines from that before we go?
Yeah.
Are you going to sing for me?
Oh, yeah, yeah. I'll sing for you.
Oh, should I start?
You start.
Hey. So long, too long. So long, too long, hey.
Arise from your sleep, Africa. Arise from your sleep, Abuja. There's work to be done, Africa. There's work to be done, Abuja. If we unite, we will be free. So long.
So long.
Too long.
Too long.
So long.
So long.
Too long.
Too long.
Hey.
That was for you,
yeah,
man.
Yeah, you see that one, yeah.
Thank you,
Ajay.
That was so beautiful. Thank you for coming. One love. We love you, we love you, we love you. And God bless you. Keep keeping on.
Thank you.
All right, if you've just tuned in, you're listening to Classic FM 97.3, the station that plays every song you know. We have just been having a wonderful time with the great legend, Majek Fashek, who's still going strong, he's looking good, he's sounding good. new stuff coming out. And if you miss this interview, you're sitting on a long thing. But don't worry, if you go to our Classic FM page, www.classicfm97.3, you will see a couple of pictures and you will see Majek in action in the studio. Hope to have him back very, very soon. He's got a new album called Rasta Gangsta that's going to hit the airways very, very soon.
Yes.
So thank you so much, Majek, for coming into the studio, and we hope to see you here at Classic FM again
thank
very, very soon. Now I'm going to play out